Look, I get that we've talked about some difficult topics. I understand. This is just who I am, you know? I'm not a fun person. I'm the dude that just shows up to a party with his own Malbec and a copy of Manufacturing Consent. And then Chomsky.
Like, hey, you guys want to talk about Manufacturing Consent for more?
Everybody's like, what? We're trying to have a good time.
I'm like, yeah, me too.
Who invited you?
I get it. If anybody needs me, I'll be the one reading.
This is me all the time. This is just who I am, right? I have these long drives, like, all across the country. So I just think about this shit all the time. I think about these issues, you know, all the problems that we have, and I think about what's going on. Are people organizing? Are we getting together? Are we doing the right thing? And sometimes the problems get too big. They get too large, and I lose sight. I lose sight of what we're actually doing. I lose sight of the solution. I lose sight of hope, and I get depressed. And then when I start getting depressed, I start getting angry. And I never want that anger to be taken out on anybody, right? Because that's my anger. I got to process that on my own. And every time I get to that level, the way I process my anger is thinking about the number zero. Oh, the number zero is amazing, folks. It's a beautiful number, very important to human history. The first time we ever saw the number zero was in India. Hindu philosophers came up with this idea, right? Before that, no one ever drew it, never came up with this idea. And it changed a whole bunch of things, right? We expanded the numeric system. We got double, triple, quadruple digits. And of course it was Hindus that came up with the number that can expand the numeric, you know, the counting system, because we needed a number that was going to help us count all our gods. So. Now, Arab scholars would come to India quite often, and they would just see what's going on, right? They would try to learn about what different parts of the world are doing, and they would meet up with these Hindu philosophers, and the Hindu philosophers would take them around, you know, show them all the cool stuff happening around. You know, they'd be like, well, that's a statue of a man next to a cow. We really think this whole trend of riding animals is going to phase out. That right there is where those fake Satanists were brutally beaten by. I don't know why they keep doing it. That is our temple. It is 8 rupees to get in there. We're working that down. And then they saw it. Zero. And no one had ever seen this number. And the Arab scholars were blown away. They were like, tell us everything you know. So they sat down, they talked about it. And the Hindu philosophers told them that zero is the idea of nothing. It's the void. It's the emptiness. Because without nothing, you can't have something. And no one had made that statement before. And it blew their minds. They were like, you got to tell us everything you know about this number. How did you come up with it? Where did... So they all learned. They learned about it. And the Arab scholars were like, we got to take this back to our people. Can we take this back to our people? Is that okay? And they were like, yeah, go. You know, if you get stuck, come back. We have food, you know. So that's what they did. The Arab scholars went back to their countries, and they spread all this knowledge, and they taught everybody. They taught their leaders, their professors, their merchants, their middle class, and everybody started adding a little bit something to it, right? They all started using this number in various different ways that nobody had thought of before, and it started changing science. It started changing mathematics. It started changing the fundamental way people were living their lives. And then they got to a point where they had more questions than answers, and the Arab scholars went back to the Hindu philosophers and said, look, this is as far as we've come, and we don't know where to go. We have all these questions, no way to figure out these answers. Can you help us out? And the Hindu philosopher said, sure, absolutely. We're going to sleep on it. The Arab said, no, wait a minute. We invented this thing called coffee, right? We have to pull an all-nighter because we need those answers. This would happen all the time, right? The Hindus would learn from the Arabs would learn from the Hindus, and they would work together constantly. And then other countries started getting involved. Southeast Asia was getting involved. Africa was getting involved. Europe was getting involved. Now everybody's adding a little bit something to it, right? They're adding their different spins to it. They're taking this information and they're doing cool shit with it. And on this continent, the Native Americans, the indigenous people of this continent, were using that number for agriculture. Two parts of the world, completely untouched by each other, came up with the same idea and used it for different purposes. That's fucking amazing, isn't it? Yeah, that's awesome. It's a very important number, zero. It's It's very fundamental for human beings. Look, without zero, Costco would be fucked. Digital language, right? That's zeros and one. That's what digital language is. Without digital language, without zero, we don't have the internet, and without the internet, we don't have porn. It's very important. And then as this number kept going around the world, somebody else asked another question that nobody had asked before. They said, wait a minute, if zero is the idea of nothing, can we have less than nothing?
Uh-oh.
Oh. Yeah, very intriguing idea. Soon after that, we invented negative numbers, and immediately after that, we invented banking. Well, I said it was important. I didn't say it was all good. We fucked up. We fucked up a few times with it. But the idea of negative numbers made zero even stronger. Right? Because that meant it was neither negative nor positive. It was right in the middle. It was that center point. It was balance. That's what it represents. Zero is the idea of all of us on a global level working together, putting our differences aside. In fact, we valued our differences. This is Hindus and Muslims working together, black people, brown people, white people working together, men, women, gay, straight. Nobody gave a shit what your identity was. All we cared about is how can we take your difference, make it a strength, and take this number as far as we can and make it applicable for everybody involved. That's what we did together. We took the idea of nothing and called it balance. We did that shit together. That's what zero really represents. But we're stuck here in all that negative, and all that hatred, and all that anger, right? Fighting with each other, competing with each other, you know, neighbor against neighbor, friend against friend. People always come up to me and they get frustrated after my shows sometimes because they go, Krish, it's really nice that you're talking about these interesting topics and all this stuff, but I don't know what to do to help. You know, I got a wife, I got kids, I got a job and a mortgage, and you know, I can't participate in activism. And I say, look, I get it. If you can participate in activism, if you can participate in legislation, you should. Absolutely, I definitely think you should. But if you can't, little things go a long way. Giving a homeless person some food or a dollar is the equivalent strength to an entire country getting health care. That's just what it is. You just helped some people. You helped somebody's life. You changed their world. That's incredible. That's a big way to do that. But we can't get to that point if we're stuck in this negative, if we're competing with each other, if we're thinking with our egos, if we're thinking we're the most important thing in the world. Because we need to start working together. We need to start appreciating our differences. And once we start doing that, we can pull ourselves out of that negative and start heading back to that center point. If we start caring about each other a little bit more, we can get back to balance. If we start treating each other with just a little bit more compassionate and a little bit more understanding, we can get back to zero. Have a good night, everybody. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Krish Mohan.